Okay, I got everybody fanned out now here. You can see that piece of spectrofiber is sticking up out of the middle, and I'm getting ready to add in some strands here. I don't know if you can see it. Well, you can see that first strand I added in right here. I got it weaved in under a couple of the other strands, and the first one I'm doing, I want to lock this spectrofiber right in the middle there. And when I add strands, I leave them longer than the other roots. These are basically some extra strands I had that I didn't put in the jig at first. And I'm gonna do about, probably gonna add in about 6 to 8 of them on this one. In the past, and it's something that you guys can do too if you like more, I used to just take a bunch of strands and kind of fold them over each other back and forth across the bottom of the tree to, you know, hold this together and keep it from splitting when I twist the roots. But since I have those, I don't know if you can still see them in there, they're kind of buried now, but those circles of wire that, you know, encircled the bunch of strands there, I think that might be a better solution than the fold over technique. And these 6 to 8 strands that I'm added in are also gonna help, you know, keep this trunk from splitting when I do the roots. And so basically what I'm going to do here with this strand that I added in right here is I'm just going to take it to one of the other strands and I'm just going to twist it and do 2 twists, and then I'm going to do the other side 2 twists to a strand. And hopefully this will go a little quicker than the fold over method. And the reason why they're so long on each other side than the other strands is once you twist up one side, if your strand is short, it's real easy to lose the other side. And the idea is to, you know, lock those strands in there. So I don't want to lose the other one. I'd rather cut off the extra wire. So I'm going to go ahead and add in all these strands, and then I'll shoot a little bit of video to show you how that looks.